youth gathering this year was held in San Antonio, Texas.
The theme for the 2013 National Youth Gathering was Live Loved.
And I think that that just means that we need to live God's love in our life every day. We need to show other people that as Christians that we can live loved through God.
1 John 2, verse 17.
This is how God showed his love among us.
He sent his one and only Son
into the world
that we might live through him.
Monday, we went to the Mass event, which was totally amazing.
It was very surprising because I knew there was going to be a lot of people and a lot of noise and lights and all that, but it was just like really amazing because all those people were there for the same reason.
It was pretty cool to see all of the youth gathered together in one big place and all being one body in Christ.
It was so loud and energetic and everybody seemed like they're having a good time.
It just felt like we all had something in common.
Every distant broken heart, every prayer, every outstretched arm.
Tuesday we went to the convention center and we went to all these different sessions with all the 25,000 people that were there.
There was a speaker last night who had gotten bit by a tick and then she was in the hospital for 4 years and she was there speaking last night. I thought that was really inspiring to know that she never gave up and that God always has a plan for us.
So the one session I went to was a pastor by the name of Bill Yonker talking about how we shouldn't just want and ask God for stuff during the hard times in our life and want to just magically fix it. But we should have a relationship with them all the time, through the good and the bad.
One of my favorite sessions that I attended was the trust session.
I thought I was legitimately going to fall asleep.
It just helped me know that God does have a plan, and if something does go wrong, it will get better, and to not lose my faith in Him just because something went wrong.
Then I started to pay attention, and I really started to understand things that we can put our trust in God and such. It's probably one of the things I'm going to take away.
The gathering affected my understanding of being a Lutheran because before I even went there, I really didn't realize how many people there actually would be. But then when you get there and you see all these people running around the hotels and going through the streets, and then you walk into the Alamo Dome, the convention center, and you realize that there's a lot of people. There's over 25,000 people here, including volunteers, the CLBs, and the actual youth. You realize that there's a lot of people and a lot of people that are just like you.
Gathering affected me as a Lutheran by making me more outgoing and talking more about my faith and more to people instead of being more to myself.
By being there with such a big mass of teenagers, it reminded me that I'm not alone in my faith. There are so many other people out there just like me who worship the same God I do. Something I would like to talk about was on Thursday night when we were walking home from the Mass event, there was like a lot of traffic, but everyone was going in the direction of their hotel, so there were a ton of people and a ton of cars, and everyone was like waving and the cars were honking the horns and people were, I don't know, it was just really cool because like probably not many of those people knew what was really going on, but like we would try to tell them and all and fill them in on what we were there for, and it was just like a cool experience because everyone felt like so together in San Antonio, so it was really cool.
One of the things I really enjoyed from the trip was walking around getting people to sign our backpacks. And this is mine. It's kind of cool everywhere. And it's really cool because years down the road, you can look back and see all the different people from different states who signed it. With the heavens we will sing, sing, sing. Was different from New Orleans, but it still had the same feeling in it.
Taking communion with 25,000 of my closest friends was fun.
Taking communion with 25,000 people is not only saying I'm doing this not because I know I have to, but because I need to, because God gave His Son for a reason, and I need that reason. I need to have this. And it's something that sticks with you, not just the fact that you're totally realizing what great a sacrifice God gave, but that He gave this sacrifice for you and 25,000 other people. When we shout your praise, lift high the name of Jesus.
The National Youth Gathering has prepared me for many things beyond just youth group.
So it's really cool to like know that there were so many other people that believed what you believe.
I think that my faith will grow stronger in the future to know that I always have God there for me. And I think that I will want to come to church more so I can praise Him for all the good things that He has done for us.
Even though I've heard the phrase, live love, this was what the entire week was about. Something that rocked my faith so strong last year, and that it was just going to be something so much more intense this year.
Looking towards God for answers and understanding His power and His glory.
This gathering has prepared me for what's next because it showed me that no matter what circumstance I'm in, no matter how hard the times may be, that God always loves me and He'll be with me and He'll guard me. And I just know that I don't have to worry about what's next because I know that it's in God's plan for me.
The time at the youth gathering has showed me how to share my faith with others and keep my faith as a strong part of my life. That way when I'm at college, I can join like the crew or a Bible study and go around talking to people about being Lutheran and what I believe in.
You realize that it is life-changing and it's so cool to see all these people, and they're all Christians, and it's just so amazing.
Forgiven. Loved. Hope is built on nothing less.